Next topic is instruction and data formats. A microprocessor operates under the control of a program. The program consists of a set of instructions stored in memory. Each instruction specifies an operation and the data on which the operation is to be performed. Thus, an instruction has two parts, namely operation code and operand. Let's see what is opcode or operation code. It is the part of the instruction that specifies the operation to be performed is called opcode or operation code. Okay, so operation code is nothing but it is the part of the instruction that specifies the operation to be performed is called operation code or opcode. Then what is operand? The data on which the operation is to be performed is called operand. So the operand may be specified in many ways. It may be 8-bit or 16-bit data, name of the registers or memory address. So the assembly language instruction has two fields, namely operation code or mnemonics field and operand field. Okay, so the operation code field always contains an instruction, mnemonics. The operand field may contain data, name of the registers, memory address, or it may be empty. So this is the definition of operand. Okay, here a few examples are given. The first example, that is move A, B. Move is the opcode or operation code. A and B are the register names. Okay, A is nothing but accumulator register. B is the another 8-bit register. Also, here operand field is nothing but name of the register is specified. Second example, add B. Add is the opcode or operation code. B is the register. So, in operand field, name of the register is specified. Third example, MPI, move immediate, A, AD. AD is the data, 8-bit data. So, in operand field, 8-bit data is specified. Okay, then fourth instruction, IN, AD. IN is the opcode. Okay, so IN instruction used by input code. AD is the 8-bit address. So, the operand field contains 8-bit address. Then fifth instruction, LDA. So, LDA expansion is load accumulator direct. Here, operand field is nothing but 4050. 4050 is nothing but 16-bit address. So, operand field contains 16-bit address. The 16-bit address content is loaded into the accumulator. That is the function of LDA. The next one, LXI H, 4080. So, LXI means load immediate. Here, operand field is 4080. So, 4080 is nothing but data. LXI load immediate. 4080 is the 16-bit data. So, this data is immediately loaded into the HL register. So, that is the function of LXI H, 4080. Okay. So, the next one is CMA. CMA is nothing but complement accumulator content. Here there is no operand field. So, already you know the operand field may contain data, name of the register, memory address, or it may be empty. Okay. So, the first two instructions, name of the register is specified. Third instruction, data is specified, 8-bit data is specified. Fourth instruction, 8-bit address is specified. Fifth instruction, 16-bit address is specified in the operand field. Then, next one, 4080, that is 16-bit data is specified in the operand field. The last instruction, there is no operand field. The operand field is empty. So, these are the examples of opcode and operand field. The next topic is classification of instructions based on length. The 8085 instructions are classified into three groups according to the length, that is word size of the instructions. They are single byte instructions, 2-byte instructions and 3-byte instructions. single byte instruction, it contains only one byte. Okay, that is operation code or opcode. Okay, here there is no data, no address field. So it contains only one byte. That byte contains operation code or opcode. Okay, so that type is called as single byte instruction. Second type, that is two byte instruction. So the two byte instruction contains two bytes. The first byte contains operation code. The second byte contains 8 bit data or 8 bit address. That is called two byte instruction. The third type, that is 3 byte instruction. So 3 byte instruction contains 3 bytes. The first byte contains operation code or opcode. The second byte contains low order 8 bit data or low order 8 bit address. The third byte contains high order 8 bit data or high order 8 bit address. So this is 3 byte instruction. So these are the examples of single, 2 and 3 byte instructions. Single byte instruction examples. The first one is move A, B. So here no data, no address. Add C. Here also no data, no address. Then third instruction, push PSW. Here also no data, no address. So name of the register is specified in the instruction. So these are all single byte instructions. Then second one is two byte instruction. The first instruction MEI A,AT. The first byte, that is MBI opcode. The second byte is data, that is 80. In second example, IN 40. The first byte contains IN opcode. The second byte contains 40, that is port address, 8 bit port address. Third example, ANI 0F. The first byte contains ANI opcode. Second byte contains 0F, that is 8 bit data. So these are the examples of 2 byte instructions. Then 3 byte instructions. First example, LDA 8050. So the first byte contains LDA opcode. The second byte contains low order address, that is 50. The third byte contains high order address, that is 80. So totally 3 bytes. Similarly, the second example, LXI H, 4080. The first byte contains LXI opcode. The second byte contains 80. The third byte contains 40. Here, 4080 is nothing but 16 bit data. Okay, the second byte 80, third byte is 40. That is LXI H 4080. And third instruction, call 8850. The first byte contains call opcode. The second byte contains low order address, that is 50. Then the third byte contains high order address, 8 bit address, that is 80H. Okay, so these are all the examples of single, 2 and 3 byte instructions. The next topic is classification of instructions based on functions. The 8085 instruction set is grouped under 5 functional headings. They are data transfer group, arithmetic group, logical group, branch group, and stack IO and machine control group. Let's see one by one. Data transfer group. This group of instruction moves data between registers. This include move instruction, load instruction, store instruction, and exchange instructions. Actually, an instruction from this group copies the content of one location called source into another location called destination. The content of the source remains the same after the execution of a data transfer instruction. So here, condition flags are not affected by any of the instruction in this group. Okay, so this is called data transfer group. The next one is arithmetic group. This group of instructions performs arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, increment, and decrement. These arithmetic operations are performed in relation to the content of the accumulator. However, the increment and decrement operations can be performed with the content of any register or register pair or referee. Here, all the condition flags are affected as per standard rules unless specified otherwise. So, this is called arithmetic group. The third one is logical group. This group of instructions performs logical operations such as AND operation, XOR operation, OR operation, complement operation, compare and rotate operations. These logical operations are performed in relation to the content of the accumulator. Okay, here all the condition flags are affected as per standard rules unless specified otherwise. The next one is branch group. This group of instruction alters normal sequential program flow. This group includes unconditional and conditional jump, call, return and restart instructions. Okay, so this is called branch instruction. The last one is stack IO and machine control group. This group includes instructions for maintaining the stack, reading from input ports, writing to output ports, disabling and enabling interrupts, setting and clearing interrupt mask, etc. It also includes no operation and halt instructions. The next topic is addressing modes of 8085 microprocessor. The methods of specifying the operand in the operand field of an instruction is called addressing modes. Okay, so addressing mode is nothing but the method of specifying the operand in the operand field of an instruction is called addressing mode. The various addressing modes are direct addressing mode, immediate addressing mode, register direct addressing mode, register indirect addressing mode, and implicit addressing mode. Let's see one by one. The first one is direct addressing mode. In this mode of addressing, the address of the operand is specified within the instruction itself. Okay, so direct addressing mode means the address of the operand is specified within the instruction itself. The actual address is part of the instruction. So, the instruction may be 2 or 3 byte length. The first byte specifies the operation to be performed. The other bytes specify the address of the I/O device or memory address. In case of 3 byte instruction, the second byte specifies the low order 8 bit of the address and the third byte specifies the high order 8-bit address. See the example. The first example, LDA 16-bit address. So, LDA is nothing but load accumulator direction. Okay. So, this is a 3-bit instruction. The content of the memory location. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction is loaded into the accumulator. So, this is the function of LDA 16-bit address. If the 16-bit address is 2050, 16-bit address is 2050, then the content of the memory location 2050 is loaded into the accumulator. So, this is the function of LDA 2050. In second example, out 8-bit address, that is output. This is a 2-byte instruction. It loads the content of the accumulator into the output port whose address is specified in the second byte of the instruction. So, this is the function of out 8-bit address. So, these two are examples of direct addressing mode. Okay, the second one is immediate addressing mode. So, in this mode of addressing, the operand is specified within the instruction itself. Okay, the operand is specified within the instruction itself. The operand may be 8-bit or 16-bit length. Hence, the instructions using immediate addressing mode will be 2 or 3 byte long. The first byte specifies the opcode. The second and third byte specifies the operand. Example 1, that is first example. MVI A, 8-bit data. Here MVI stands for move immediate. The IO instruction moves the second byte of the instruction into the accumulator. It is a 2-byte instruction. Second example, LXI H,16-bit data. So LXI stands for load extended register path EDH. The above instruction loads the second and the third byte of the instruction into the register L and H respectively. It is a 3-byte instruction. The instruction LXI H, 2050 loads, that is 50 loads into L register, and high order, that is 20, is loaded into H register. So this is the explanation of LXI H, 16-bit data. Third one is register direct addressing mode. In this mode of addressing, the name of the register is specified as the address of the operand. Okay, name of the register is specified as the address of the operand. Thus, register addressing mode is used whenever the operand is stored in CPU register. The instruction using register addressing mode are typically single byte instructions. The advantage of register addressing mode is its speed, because the CPU register can be accessed within a shorter time than a memory location. Here examples are move C, B and add E. The first example, move C, B, this instruction moves the content of register B to register C. The second one, that is add E, this instruction adds the content of register E with the content of accumulator, and the result is placed in the accumulator. So that is the function of add E register. The next one is register indirect addressing mode. In this mode of addressing, the content of register pair is used as address of the operand. So the content of register pair is used as the address of the operand. Here the specified register pair contains 16-bit address of the memory location where the operand is stored. Okay. So here example, move B, M. This instruction load the register D with the content of memory location whose address is specified in HL pair. For example, if register H contains 20. Okay. Register H contains 20 and the L register contains 50, then instruction move B, M will move the content of memory location 20, 50 to D register. Okay, here if register H contains 20, L register contains 50, then the instruction move B, M will move the content of memory location 20, 50 to register D. So that is the function of move D, M. Second example, LDAXB. LDAX stands for load accumulator indirect. The instruction loads the accumulator with the content of the memory location whose address is specified in PC register pair. For example, if B contains 20 and C register contains 60, then LDAXB instruction will move the content of memory location 2060. Okay, 2060 to the accumulator. Content of memory location 2060 to the accumulator. That is the function of LDAXB register. Okay. The last one is implicit addressing mode. There are certain instructions which operate on the content of the accumulator. Such instructions do not require the address of the operand. The type is called as implicit addressing mode. Since the operand is implied in the instruction itself, so they are called implicit addressing mode or implied addressing mode. Here examples are CMA, RAL, RAR, etc. So CMA is nothing but complement accumulator. Here there is no operand field. RAL and RAR, these two instructions also no operand field. So CMA is nothing but complement accumulator. REAL means rotate left through carry. RAR means rotate accumulator right side through carry. So these are the examples of implicit addressing mode.